The PVPC government has honored its commitment to improve the lives of residents of Albouystown who have begun to benefit from $1.5 billion worth in community enhancement works.
I live in this community 53 years. The developer I see in it is real reasonable and nice that this place become looking beautiful to me. Even to last night, two girls pass walking and say, oh God, Bungle, this place looks lovely and nice that I could walk straight here to point A to point B.
How you feel about being employed on this project?
Real grateful because I get in a little dirty in my pocket and I keep humbling myself in a corner and I keep every day I come out and I keep getting strength what God give me for keep doing what I could do.
Ms. Smith, what do you think about this upgrade to Independence Boulevard?
I come and meet it and I gotta go with it. But I think it's a good idea for me and the kids. I'm a mother of three children.
Here with Margaret Rampasad, who lives along the Independence Boulevard, which is currently under a host of rehabilitation works to the tune of $1.5 billion. Now, Margaret, share your thoughts on this project.
Oh, it's very good because we could cross better, we got a better facilities to sit in the afternoon, have a nice view, afternoon walk, and also it's very important with the traffic, because it will ease the traffic from the public road out there, which is Lombard Street. They could take the shortcut now through here when it's finished. So I really agree with this.
Do you think it will also help in terms of changing the perception of the communities of Albouystown and the Penitents? Persons might have a bad idea or a bad connotation of the communities. You think this will help to change persons' perceptions?
Yes, I think so, because remember now it will be beautifying now and it won't be a bad stain anymore on Albouystown.
It's a nice thing. Nice thing the government doing for me. Nice. For like bring up the Albouystown, bring up the ghetto, like rise it, make it look nice, real nice.
Love the project, boss, for the area. This is going to big up this place here. Real thing, buddy. Right. The ghetto people.
So I'm here talking with Manzoor Ali, a resident of Albouys Street, Albouystown. Now, Manzoor, a lot of development happening in the area. Share your thoughts on what you've been seeing here with Independence Boulevard.
Yeah, it is a wonderful idea for having this road project here.
Now, do you think a project like this would change the stigma that is usually associated with a community like Albouystown? Persons would usually have a bad connotation. Would you think this would lift the spirit and the nature of the community?
Of course, yes, it would. Because the people in the community would love to have this kind of project going on.
And in terms of having a safe space for the youths, the youngsters in the community, and even the elderly to come out, relax, and just enjoy their community, do you see that as a good thing to uplift the community?
Yes, yes, they will. Everybody will. This place will be full of people upon the afternoon sitting down. And it'll be a nice walk for the elderly people, for jog. Sometimes people jog right here, they go to the National Park. You know, spend a lot of money, transportation, go up and come down and so. Yeah, and the chairs then would be very, very important for the elderly people to you relax out here, especially like in the afternoon. It can be a one. People in the here till midnight.
Well, most I can say about it is that it's a nice idea. The project is very nice. It's very becoming. I mean, as a matter of fact, I didn't expect this, but it's very nice. But I don't know. It's very. It's very good. It's very nice. It raised the outlook of everything. It raised the outlook of the community, and I feel sure that prices for house lots would be going up. Because of this.
It's good. It's very, very good. Good project. I like it. Like it very much.
I would say upliftment. It's been an upliftment in the community in a whole that, you know, the youths can see what their grandmother, grandfather seen before. I mean, we show them in a picture that they could see well. It's a different place. Most of the people, since it's an Albouystown, it's a negativity. There's educated people in this community that have certificates in various parts. So I think looking at this now, you're able, when you go for ask a job and you say Albouystown, nobody ain't trying to discriminate you. Right, because I know the door and how it used to be. I is one of the person who had a shop on the Sponge Trench. And not to remove. The whole of the ghetto knows that. But what I'm seeing, the upliftment, is for the next generation. Not me. It's like I had my part, the next generation.
I'm feeling good being a part of this project because of our enjoying the work.
Well, I was born in Charlestown, 16 house in Ketley Street. I came here a little child, a little boy, like 5-6 years of age. So I know the entire Albouystown area. Over here was Corio. There's no orange juice and thing and chicken over here. This was the Pond Trench Dam, the Pond Trench. Punch used to run up and down, up and down. So I grew here. I know about here. I move out and go out to come back here and live. So I knew a lot about Pond Trench. But this here, I was here when this road, when this trench full in the 60s. It was filled in the 60s. They had a high bridge there, they had one there, they had one also. And Pond used to pass under them. And as a little boy, we used to jump on the pond and pull out cane. But this here now is very far by storm. This Pond Trench road, this road that we built in. Because I hear it can be a double road, no?
Yes.
It would be very good. This is very good what we doing here. I just sit down here and admire these what's going on out here. Because I know someday it's gonna be a benefit for everybody. Everybody in Albouystown. You see people will left and gone outside and come back. We're gone outside and glad to come back here and live. I tell you, when this Albouystown is turned to, they're glad to come back here and live. They might just sell the place outside and come back here.
The works will be conducted through the Ministry of Public Works Urban Enhancement Projects for South Georgetown. Major upgrades will also be done to 1.2 kilometers of Vlissengen Road, more popularly known as Cemetery Road, from Princes Street to Mandela Avenue. The PVPC government is committed to bringing improvement to the lives and livelihoods of every Guyanese.